Hey everybody, this is the new Nikon Z5. We've been lucky enough to have a couple of these at the Nikon school over the past couple of weeks for us to test. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to run you through some of the headline specifications of this camera. And then also I'm going to talk to you about what we're going to be doing to help you kind of learn more about this camera as we go forward. So, headline specifications first of all. We have a 24 megapixel full frame sensor. So this will join both the Z6 and the Z7 in creating a really nice range of full frame cameras in the Nikon Z range. On that 24 megapixel sensor, we also have 273 autofocusing points. You can also shoot from ISO 100 all the way up to 51,000 if you need to in low light situations. The layout of the camera itself, in terms of buttons and ergonomics, is almost identical to what you might be used to from a Z6 or Z7. So especially if you've used those cameras before and you're happy with the button layout, this is going to be the same button layout on this camera as well. And that also then means that you get the great build quality, weather sealing, and ergonomics that you're used to from the Z6 and Z7 as well. The only thing that this camera doesn't have on the outside of the camera is it doesn't have a top plate display like you'll find on the Z6 and Z7. Instead, Nikon's moved the mode dial, so the mode dial is now over on that right-hand side rather than being on the left-hand side of the camera itself. The viewfinder in this camera is the same high-resolution, high-quality viewfinder that you're also used to in the same Z6 and the Z7. It's really easy to work with and easy to look through even over longer periods of time. The Z5 is actually the first camera in the Z series range that will offer dual card slots. So we'll have two SD card slots in this camera. Both of them will support UHS-II speed memory cards as well. That'll obviously allow you to back up in camera if you need to. The Z5 will also allow you to record in 4K at 30 frames per second. However, when you do record in 4K, there is a crop that's applied to that video recording, unlike when you're recording on a Z6 or a Z7, for example. You can also record in full HD if you need to, rather than recording in 4K.
The Nikon Z5 also has a lot of features that you might find in some other Nikon models, like the Z6, Z7, D850, or D780. The first one of those is called multiple exposure. This allows you to take multiple frames and combine them into one single image. The next option is called interval timer shooting. Interval timer shooting allows you to choose a specific start, day, and time. Another really useful option that I really love using as well is called time-lapse movie. This allows you to create time-lapse videos in your camera without any of the external editing process required. The camera does all the hard work for you. You can give the camera a particular interval, and you can also give the camera a particular shooting time. Another great feature that's available on the Nikon Z5 is focus shift shooting. What this does is it allows you to take a number of different images, and each image will have a slightly different point of focus or depth of field.
So there's some of the headline specifications, and we think this is going to be a great entryway into the Nikon Z series system, and especially a great entryway into a full frame camera system. If you've never shot full frame before, or if you want to try out some of the full frame Z series lenses, the Z5 could be the way to do that.